Welcome back to Mike's Archery's YouTube, and we're going to be checking out a brand new camera on the market this year, the WiseEye. Now, frankly, this is completely new technology. It is a cell camera, which, you know, has been around for years and something that a lot of companies have. But the technology that's built into this particular camera is far and above anything else we've seen on the market, especially on the app side of it. So this camera, first of all, just some of the basic things about it. It's a 12 megapixel camera with a high resolution image sensor in it. It's got a higher resolution image sensor than anything else on the market, even though it's only 12 megapixels. So when you're seeing those numbers from all those other manufacturers, frankly, they're just numbers. We've known for years that if you put a good lens behind it and a good camera and good sensors, you can get great pictures out of lower megapixels. And that is the case with this camera. It's a better camera than everything else out there when it comes to image resolution.
It's got a built-in GPS,
which is going to allow you the function of not only pinpointing where that camera is at on a map and logging that information to knowing where that's at, but it's also going to allow you the ability that if somebody does steal this camera, the GPS coordinates are going to come back up. You're going to be able to locate this camera and retrieve it whenever somebody tries to take it from you, even though you'll probably have a picture on your phone almost immediately when they do it.
The next feature we noticed on this camera is going to be a 100-foot IR flash range on it. So it is a true blacked out IR, so you're not going to see any of that orange glow at night like you do with some standard IR cameras. And it's going to have a 100-foot range built into that. Frankly, that's about the norm on most of your high-end cameras is going to be a 100-foot flash range. But that's toward the top end of reaching out there and really getting a good quality image of an animal at night. And, of course, the daytime images are fantastic on it as well. So you're not going to have any issues there picking things up at 30, 40 yards out there and being able to see what's out in a food plot
beyond that, depending on where your camera's set up. The next feature of this camera is these giant antennas on top. And frankly, you can obviously, it sticks out on this camera, but this is an important function because most cameras out there have a little tiny antenna or no antenna at all sticking out of it. And you always have trouble getting reception depending on where you put these cameras. I know here in Southern Ohio for us, if you drop down off the top of a ridge, getting signal is almost impossible. But these are a dual set of long range antennas built into this camera. And it's gonna allow you to get more places, pick up better signal, and be able to send your images faster to your phone and to that app to be able to see those images. The dual antennas on here are actually 4 times stronger than any other cell camera on the market, and that's each antenna. So it's actually 8 times stronger than any other camera as far as being an output to be able to get those images sent to your phone. And frankly, that's gonna be one of the game changers and the separators in this camera and everything else on the market is being able to put it in more places and getting better signal in some of those sketchy places on the farm so you can get those images back from what you want to see and where that deer's coming from.
I have 1 to 2 bars with an AT&T iPhone here in the shop, and the camera has full signal, complete full bars across the board right here, and it's an AT&T camera as well. So the power of these antennas is going to be the big difference between this camera and everything else on the market. It's just a better all-around camera setup and better antennas that's going to give you better signal.
The other great thing that this causes is with these dual antennas, it's going to allow this camera to actually send video and a higher resolution picture than any other camera on the market. Now, if you've messed with some of those cell cameras out there, you realize that most of them will not send video to the app or to your phone. This camera gives you that ability to send bigger, higher res images, but also all those video clips, if you want to run video clips, you can also get those sent directly to your phone as well. The trigger speed on this camera is 0.35 seconds, which frankly, it's not the fastest trigger speed out there, but it's plenty fast enough. It's faster than most of your cameras, and it's going to give you all the pictures that you need, and it's not going to miss any pictures of any of the animals. As we go into the app and talk about how this camera truly functions and some of the abilities that it has to separate pictures, when it's picking up those pictures and how it separates them out is really amazing. So the application behind this camera is truly where this camera shines. The camera has the ability to send every single picture to your app and to the phone or the website, wherever you want to check out those pictures. Most all of your other camera manufacturers out there in the app in the background, if you put it on a burst mode or a really short time frame where you're taking a lot of pictures every 10 seconds or so, they only have the ability to send those pictures every so often. This camera has the ability to actually send every picture all the time. So if you put it on a really short burst mode and you're taking a ton of pictures, it's going to upload every single one of those pictures into the app on the website. So you have the ability to actually look at every single picture in real time as it's taking them.
So even though this is an AT&T camera, they are coming out with a Verizon version here in just a few weeks. It'll be available as well. But frankly, it doesn't really matter. What matters is that you have signal. And if you can put one of these cameras in the woods, and you, whether it's AT&T or Verizon, it doesn't matter what your phone service is there locally or what phone service you have, the camera is going to pick up and work off of whatever tower is there in the area. And if one of those is better, you may want to choose Verizon or AT&T, but that doesn't match up with your phone. If I had an AT&T phone and wanted to run a Verizon camera, those are all going to work together because it's working in an application in the background, and it doesn't really matter what your phone is running off of. I know we get that question a lot. You know, I have an AT&T phone, or I have a T-Mobile, or I have something else that may be a regional carrier. Will this camera work on my phone? It doesn't matter. The camera is independent of your cell phone, and it's going to work off whatever tower is in the area. So frankly, if you buy an AT&T model camera or you buy a Verizon model camera and your phone provider is something else, it doesn't matter. Choose the camera that's best for you, but both of them are going to work and both of them are going to pick up a ton of signal and work better than anything else in your area if you've looked at other camera models. Once you get this camera, setup is as simple as it can be. All you need to do is locate the barcode here, which is basically a serial number inside the camera, download the app on your phone, plug that number into the app, and you're ready to go. This camera has no setup. There's no real buttons in here that you really need to mess with. Turn it on, it's ready to go. It's going to sync itself up with your phone based on that serial number. So the setup on this camera is super simple and doesn't take a lot of time. It does run off basic SD cards. Obviously, higher the SD card, you want to use a good quality SD card, at least a class 10 or higher. That is important, but it does run off standard SD cards rather than the micros. The new WiseEye camera does run off 12 AA batteries. That's about the norm for most cameras these days, especially in a cell cam, to run off about 12 batteries. Now, the other option that they do have, and it's an accessory, is the solar panel. And this is a general solar panel that they're making to go with this camera, hooks up with a wire, but it's going to hold a charge, and you can actually use this solar panel with the camera without batteries. So if you're the guy that just wants to run this and you're in a secure place that gets plenty of light, this solar panel is going to allow you to run this camera without having batteries in it. The other really cool thing is that if you happen to have it like right next to your ground blind and have a cable long enough, or if you get low on your battery on your phone, you can actually charge other devices with this solar panel. So let's say you get in the morning and you just want to charge your phone, or you got another device that you want to charge, you can actually tap into the power that's in this solar panel and charge other devices with it as well. Now let's dig into the app on this camera. And frankly, the app is truly what separates it apart from every other camera on the market. The functionality of this app has so many things going on in it and so much information. It's got more than we've seen from any other camera on the market so far, laid out in a way that's going to be really easy to use, separate things out for you, categorize it, even tell you when and how to hunt a specific animal. So as we look at the features on this thing, the first thing it has is species recognition. Now, there's a few cameras out there that claim to be able to separate your buck pictures from your doe pictures and things of that nature, but this camera goes one step further. The software that's built into this is built on a facial recognition platform that used for security and other things, but they have fine-tuned this to pick out animal species. So what it does is it's going to separate into four different categories right off the bat of species, whether it be deer, turkey, hogs, or other. So you've got those four categories. It's going to pick out each one of those species and categorize in a folder in the app for you whether it's one of those animals. Now, if for some reason you've got other animals on camera, whether it's bear or elk or coyotes or whatever else you may have running in your area, it's going to separate those photos out from everything else, and it's going to put it in the other category. From there, it's going to pick out every deer that you have and put it in a deer folder. It's going to pick out all the turkey pictures you have and put it in a turkey folder, and hogs and put that in a hog folder. What's really nice about that is now you don't have to sort through hundreds or even thousands of pictures to figure out what you have a picture of. The next thing it has the ability to do is to take a specific animal.
Let's say you have a specific buck on your property, or maybe even multiple bucks on your property that you're watching, and you want to be able to know where that animal is and what it's doing. You can take that specific animal with this camera, tag that photo, go in once you get a picture of him, tag that photo, name him whatever you want to name him, buck one, buck two, lucky, I don't know. But from there, you're able to track what that deer is doing. It will follow that specific deer every time he goes past one of your cameras. It's going to put it in its own special place, and you're going to be able to know what that animal is doing, when it's doing it, how it's doing it, and really fine-tune your hunting so that you can capitalize on the best times to kill that animal. Now, let's say you have identified that specific buck on your property that you want to hunt. Now, once you have done that, this app is not only going to keep track of that animal, but it's going to keep track of all the other things that are happening while that animal is moving through. It's going to take a look at the temperature at the time that that buck is moving, and it's going to tell you when and if he's moving at certain temperatures during the day. It's also going to tell you the wind speed and the wind direction when that buck is moving and when he likes to move based on those patterns. It's also going to give you moon phase, and it's also going to break out the barometric pressure for you as well. All of that is going to be fine-tuned to that specific animal. So if you're getting pictures of that animal at 6 o'clock in the evening with a west wind at 65 degrees, it's going to track all that information and tell you when is the best time to hunt that animal and when is the best wind to be able to hunt that animal as well, so that you can properly place your tree stands or your blinds and be right where you need to be when you need to be there. There are other basic features in the app that you're going to love to look at as well, from just really quality weather data that's going on in your area, as well as the GPS location on the camera. So if you move a camera or not sure exactly where you put those cameras, you got a bunch of them out, you're going to be able to locate where all your cameras are and overlay them on a map as well, so you can kind of see where they're at on your property. There's just a ton of features and a ton of information that this camera can give you that any other camera is not going to. The price points on these things are right there with your top-end cameras. MSRP on the camera is $299, and MSRP on the solar panel is $59.99. So if you set those up together, you got a nice little package that's going to allow you to get in the woods and give you more information than you've ever had from a cell camera. The plan on these cameras at the highest end is $14.99 for 5,000 pictures. So not a real bad price point on the plans. They do have other plans, some basic plans that'll fit just about any budget, but the top end plan is $14.99 for 5,000 pictures. And then if you add a camera, it's another $9.99 for each camera that you add for that top end platform for another 5,000 pictures. The other cool thing that they had is you're able to share those pictures between plans. So if you have two cameras and one's taking a ton of pictures and the other one's only taking a few, you've got 10,000 pictures to be able to use between those two cameras. So if you've got one camera that's really burning it up and taking, you know, 3,000-4,000 pictures or 5,000 pictures, and the other one's only taking a couple thousand, you are not going to run out of your plan. You're still going to have 10,000 pictures to be able to share between both those cameras. So overall, what we've seen from the WiseEye, if you're that guy that wants to really know what your deer are doing on your property and really want to hone in on specific animals, I think you got to take a look at the WiseEye. It's going to give you features and information that you never thought you even needed to be able to hunt that deer and really capitalize on the best time in your season and make some great kills and be able to find every animal on your property and what they're doing. Now, one of the last features of this app that we frankly think is really cool, if you're already got a plan and you've got your camera from WiseEye, you can now take all of your pictures from all your other cameras and upload them to the app. So let's say you've got a couple other cameras on your property and in places that you can't get signal, and they're taking pictures of the bucks that you're looking for. You can now take all the pictures from those cameras with your SD card, import them into your computer, and upload them to the app. It will then sort your pictures and put those pictures in the proper folders so that you can see where that buck is at in other places where you don't have this camera. Now, on top of that, let's say you're the guy that, frankly, you're not ready for this, but you want to have some of these cool features that the app offers. You can actually download the app, and for $4.99 a month, you can go in and pull your other cell cameras or other cameras on your property,
upload those pictures to this app, and it will sort those pictures for you and show you that information of what's going on while those deer are there. So frankly, there's a lot of options and a lot of features in this app that we have found really cool, and this is one of them. The fact that you can pull from other camera makers and other brands of cameras and actually import your pictures into this app and sort through those so that you don't have to look through all the doe pictures and raccoon pictures on your feeders and whatnot. It just makes sense to me that it's a really cool function that you should be able to take other stuff and use what you already have. Thanks for tuning in to Mike's Archery once again. As always, hit that subscribe button, turn on that bell notification, and leave us some comments in the comment section below. We always love to hear what our customers have to say. Check us out on social media and give us some likes on there as well.